Could you tell our audience about the traumatic incident in your life?
Yes, 1995, 12th of February, I was in a paragliding camp. I was always an adventure junkie, and this was at Milan, and it used to be a weekend camp. So Saturday morning I would go to the camp, return in the evening, Sunday morning again go to the camp and return in the evening. And this was the last day of the camp over a period of a month and a half, and it was a Sunday. And once I reached there and they told me that the glider had developed some kind of a tear. And these people were from Manali, so they were not localized, and one of them went to the town because the site was quite far from the town. So went to the town and went to a local tailor and stitched the tear up and came back. And there were few of us who were eagerly still waiting that we would do a flight and go back. They did mention that, you know, it was later in the day because you need a particular thermal in the air to fly. And they said that, you know, the wind has picked up, and again Mumbai is a sea coast, you know, so ideally not a good place to paraglide, which we realized much later. And yet I was into it, and I said, okay, it doesn't matter, let's do this flight. So the last flight at 12 o'clock on 12th of Feb 1995, I took off from the hill, and before you knew it, I was to go like this, and I was swerved and I crashed down on the rocky terrain. So it was completely rocky, and there were just two controls, one is a brake and one is the accelerator. So when I saw that I was whirling towards the ground, I just pulled the brake and I fell down. I was completely conscious when I fell down, and I fell on my back like this, on my hips, and I was lying there. I had not a scratch, not a spot of blood anywhere on my body. But what I did realize, because I had doctors in my family and we used to have a lot of these intellectual discussions, was that I knew that there was something majorly wrong with my legs, because I couldn't feel a thing. And immediately the people around, the ones who were there for the flight, the ones who were managing the entire thing, they came around. And I must tell you this, Dharmendra, that a life-changing event happened when I took that flight and I fell down. From the point that I fell down and I knew that there was something major, everything happened as if there was this divine intervention. There were angels all around me who were ensuring that I got the best, whether it was in terms of, you know, medical care, the doctors, specialists, people around. There was an election rally happening, and the gentleman who was conducting it, one of the, you know, MLAs or whoever, he got his ambassador card, and I was put in his car, you know, straight. I was carried in the tent cloth, you know, by four people and put there. I was taken to a local doctor there. Somebody had just gone in advance and spoken to them, and he decided to go for lunch. And see, even that was a positive. I'm telling you, everything was positive which happened after an accident. And I tell you this because it's, you know, I'm able to put it all together and piece it together and distill all the sequence of events. And I was taken to another nursing home and doctor, and he turned out to be a messiah. He turned out to be my, the God who saved Dr. Ritin Pradhan. So he's one of the best orthopedic doctors on this planet, not only because of his skills, but because of his human persona. And he is so holistically aware and so intellectually up there that he was able to approach the whole thing in a manner that while I was lying down on the stretcher, he got a stretcher, he asked me, you know, the questions about, you know, when was the last time I had water, where I could feel, where I could not feel. So he assessed it. He gave me the injection, which is supposed to, you know, give you maximum recovery if we had that injection in the first 4 hours.
Right. So the golden period.
The golden period. So he was doing all the right things, and he was such a gentle human being. And he told me, okay, so who's there in your family? And the surprising part was that my brain was like functioning just normally, and I was communicating very coherently, and there was tremendous pain. But what everybody was asking was able to say, okay, my brother, and these are the numbers, my sister, and these are our numbers. And he was the one who spoke to my family. And he said it in a manner which was not panicking, which was communicating, you know, something that, okay, she's had this, and we need to take her to a hospital, and you know, it will be good if we take her to a Sion hospital, etc. And my family also, my sister was at Kandivali because she was married, and my brother was at, on Sunday he was working, his office at that time was in Dadar, and he took a decision and he said, doctor, let's take her to Hinduja. Mm-hmm. Okay, so again that decision about Sion Hospital, about Hinduja, and then I just held Dr. Pradhan's hand and I told him, doctor, will you please come with me, because all these people just don't know anything about my condition. And he just looked at me and said, okay. So he took a decision that let's not go by road, because at that time the roads were very bumpy, it would have taken us a long time, and he said, okay, we'll take the train. So he was with me along with the entire group of the organizers, and the journey started from there, and we reached the station, and I still remember we reached Hinduja Hospital. I was in the casualty, and because Dr. Pradhan knew quite a few doctors, so he said Dr. Bhojraj is one of the finest and the best spine surgeons in the country, and he consulted at Hinduja. So he said, let's wait for him. So he just took a shot. It was a Sunday. Let's wait for him. At that time, in 95, there were the pagers.
Right. Yeah.
So they paged for Dr. Bhojraj. And wonder of wonders, Dr. Bhojraj was in his chambers preparing for a spine conference, which is starting the next day at Hinduja.
Oh, I see. Okay.
And he immediately came down, and he started evaluating me. He said, okay, fine, we do your MRI, we do your X-ray, and we get you onto the operation theatre.
Wow, that's amazing.
So, I was operated the same night. I was in absolute safe hands with Dr. Pradhan, with my family members, and Dr. Bhojraj. And that's how I realized that this was a spinal cord injury, and the effort had to begin from that day.